Hey everybody! I'm here today to tell you how to negotiate a car deal. This is a great way to save tons of money. Let's get right into the video. You want to start off by discussing the price of the vehicle that you want to purchase, okay? Or that you want to lease, finance, purchase, it doesn't matter. The vehicle that you want. Don't worry about anything else. They're going to try and sucker you into talking about all different things. Listen, just talk about the price of the vehicle. I want this vehicle. The sticker price, or the MSRP, the manufacturer suggested retail price of that vehicle is, let's say, $50,000. What price can we do for this vehicle? You're going to negotiate back and forth, blah, blah, blah. They're going to give you a price for the vehicle. You're going to agree upon a price for that vehicle, okay? Ignore any incentives. They're going to try and tell you, oh, hey, we got $3,000 off if you go with this. Ignore it all, okay? Only deal with the incentives for that specific model, let's say. But you're going to ignore any other incentives, anything about financing, paying cash, warranty, whatever. Ignore it all. Discuss the price of the vehicle, okay? This way you know what they're willing to give you the vehicle for. And I'll explain why in a moment. You want to stay tuned for the whole thing so you understand exactly how this negotiation tactic works, okay? You have to understand also the dealer needs to make some money. They're not going to do the deal if they're going to lose money. No dealer will. If a dealership does a deal where they're going to lose money constantly, they're not going to be in business anymore. So you have to understand that you got to be willing to understand that they need to have some profit in the deal, okay? They need to have some skin in the game per se. I don't even know what that term means, but I've heard it being used all the time. Like you gotta be involved in it. They need to make profit. They need to want to make the deal. Okay? So basically, once you negotiate back and forth and you agree upon the certain price for the car, okay? Then you want to discuss incentives. Oh, also, I'm paying cash. So I know that I just read online and saw, you know, that there's like a $5,000 back bonus. You get $5,000 off the car when you pay cash. They're going to say, well, you didn't tell me about that. I know I didn't. I didn't on purpose, because the dealership will likely get that $5,000 back from the manufacturer. So if they don't give that discount to you in addition to negotiating the car, then that means they're going to be profiting off the $5,000. They're going to be profiting off of you paying cash. You want to save money off of you paying cash. You don't want the dealership to profit off of you paying cash. So you negotiate the price of the car, and then you look for any incentives. So maybe there's a financing. Like if you finance, you get $3,000 off. If you're leasing, you're getting $1,000 off or $100 off a month. Whatever. You're going to incorporate those incentives after you negotiate the price of the car, okay? So then you incorporate the incentives. So let's say the car is $50,000 sticker price. You negotiate it down to $45,000. Plus, you're paying cash, so now you get a $5,000 incentive from the manufacturer that goes to the dealer, that goes to you. So now you're only paying 40 G's for the car. Fantastic. You save 20% on that car, okay? Sorry about that. If you use these tactics effectively, you can definitely save a lot of money, okay? So then you want to deal with the trade-in if you have a trade-in. So let's say you have a car that you're trading in. Once you've negotiated the price, now you're dealing with the trade-in, okay? So let's say you're getting that car for $40,000, like I just said, the car that you're purchasing. Now we're dealing with my trade-in. Well, I'm trading in this vehicle. What are you going to give me for it? They're going to say, well, you didn't tell me about that. I know I didn't. Because it's part of the negotiation tactic. It's part of the strategy. So now you negotiate your trade-in separately. So they're going to figure out what they think your vehicle's worth. Okay? And this way you know, if they're offering you $2,000 for your car, and you know you can get $10,000 by selling it privately, sell it privately. They're not going to try and scam it into the deal somehow, okay? Very simple. Then once you deal with your trade-in, then you deal with your warranties and your extras. So you want to buy an extended warranty, then you deal with that. Because if you try, they're going to try and work the warranty. Woo, that vehicle was really close to my truck. They're going to try and work the warranty into the deal to sort of make additional profit. If you deal with each thing specifically by itself, it's easier for you to save a lot of money, because then you can work with each thing individually. What car dealerships do, what car salespeople are trained to do, is to work all of the things into one deal. So like, you know, let's say you can afford $500 a month. Okay, we're going to work with that. We'll take your trade in and we'll give you this car for $500 a month. You don't know what you paid for the car. You don't know what you paid for the trade, what they gave you for the trade in. You don't know what kind of warranty you you got what you paid for the warranty, okay? Deal with each thing individually. That is how to negotiate a car deal and save tons of money, okay? I've used this with my own vehicles that I've purchased and with, I've helped family and friends, family members and friends negotiate their cars. I've probably saved people, I don't know, $100,000 probably over the years by helping this person save 5 G's, this person save 2 G's, this person save 7 G's. You can use these strategies. You can save a lot of money. You don't need to pay a crazy amount for your car. Get a car that you can afford, but make sure you're getting a good deal on the car as well. And that's basically it. That is how to negotiate a car deal and save tons of money. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.